Hello everyone, thanks for joining us. We've come a long way with the soil samples you collected over the past few videos. Let's just have a recap. First, we mixed the soil with the water and spread it onto a special kind of jelly called agar. Then, we picked the bacteria of greatest interest to us and separated them from the rest using a technique called streaking. After that, we took the DNA from inside the cells and made multiple copies of a particular gene using PCR. The gene that we're interested in is like a genetic fingerprint, which we can use to identify the DNA. Last video, we were using electrophoresis to confirm that the PCR had worked. Now we have enough DNA to sequence, and today we're going to prepare it. The DNA has to be sent away to a company that specializes in sequencing it. They have machines that lets them read the DNA code. Because they ask us to provide the DNA at a specific concentration, we need to first find out how much we have, so we know how much to dilute it by. In order to work out how much DNA we have, we use a machine called a nanodrop, so named because it only uses a tiny amount of DNA. We only use a single microliter, which is a million times smaller than a liter. The machine has now given us a reading, which we can use to prepare our sample for sequencing. For each sample, we have two tubes. This is because DNA is made of two strands that are sequenced separately. To each tube, we add water, our primers, and our sample. Now we can send them away for sequencing. Next video, we'll be doing bioassays to see if any of our bacteria produce chemicals that can kill other microbes.